from the city of Newburyport. Good morning. It's great to be back again talking with all of you. And while the Celtics were pulling off a miracle in Boston last night, we had our own miracle in Newburyport. Citizens of Newburyport passed a debt exclusion last night for $72 million. We don't pass debt exclusions. It just doesn't happen. But this was a 14-month campaign that I have to say was all about communication, communication, communication. We used every media outlet that we could. This was for our school projects and a long overdue, 30 years we've been trying to put a senior community center in Newburyport. So this was just a huge effort, a huge push with hundreds of volunteers, an organization called Port Pride. And I am just so pleased that we were able to move this forward. We have an elementary school that was built in 1954 with 38% of the kids being educated in modular classrooms. They're trailers with mold, and you know, just hadn't been able to get in the pipeline with the Municipal Building Authority. Had been really difficult, and we're in the new model school program. We're working with a wonderful architect out of Cambridge, HMFH. It's a $38 million project with what MSBA, they say they don't participate in, they won't contribute to the cost share, but we're getting about 47% reimbursement, which is very exciting. We'll be closing another school, which is a pre-KK, again, 1928 school in the South End, and I'd like to see that turn into development for more senior affordable housing, take some of the sale of that project and set up an endowment for our schools, because in communities like Newburyport, because you're looking at your funding formula for schools is based on your property tax rate, we get a couple $1 million and we're all said and done because we have a charter school too. So we're always struggling to fund our schools. So I thought, that might help also. So we have this project that will be breaking ground in January. The new model school is a wonderful program with the MSBA where you actually pick a school that's already been built. So it's an accelerated project to get an extra 5 percentage points for jumping in the model school. And we hope to be breaking ground in January with that. The next is our Knock Mullen, which is two schools, an upper elementary and a middle school, that are combined into one site. Again, a school that was built in the 1970s, has electric heat, all kinds of energy issues. So this one isn't going to be glamorous in terms of what you actually see when it's been renovated at $27 million, but it's all kinds of ADA, energy, single pane windows will be replaced, a whole new energy management system will switch to gas. It was one of those schools where you had that open concept back in the 60s where you had these movable curtains and all these, you could reshape all of your classrooms. It's a disaster because you've got these big curtains taking up all this room and, and moving these not solid walls between all the classrooms in the middle school. So this would be a huge change there also. We have 1,770 solar panels on the school that we put back on after, so we'll continue with our green initiatives in the community. So very excited about that.